Hello and welcome to Kimba Bushcraft. Well, today I'm in my camp again and I actually have some new stuff, some new additions to my shelter I would like to show you. It's been a busy week. I made some things that I have put on the walls and bought another thing, and I would like to show you that now. So hang on. Yeah. Can you see it? My new things to my shelter. A little bit Viking-like decoration. And I'll show you in detail more about these things. First of all, I made a shield, of course Viking inspired, just a piece of plywood that I painted with some color that we call Almu color. It means it's mostly earth colors. And these colors have been used for a generation, and I love it. So this is the shield, and over here you can see another thing. And I have to explain that a little bit. This is of course my logo from my Kimba Bushcraft logo, and I changed the logo a little bit, made it a little bit more dark and not so colorish. So, and my wife, who is a graphic employee, has printed this for me on something that is waterproof. It is canvas, and I put it on. I made this frame from branches out from my garden and put some strings on. I'll take you closer. Yeah, here can you see the details. The prints on canvas, and I put this little brass, I don't know if it's called rivets, but, and then the string from yew twine. And the inspiration of course is from the old trappers that put on their fur skin on such frame to tighten up the skin or the fur they have skin from a deer and other animals of course. So that was my intention, that it should be a little bit old school and a little bit rough. So I hope you like. And last but not least, these reindeer skin. Oops, this way. Yeah, I was lucky. I bought them second hand, and I got two furs from a reindeer. And it cost me only 500 kroners, which is about $75. And that's cheap. You can see it's overlapping here. So they are quite big and very, very thick. But they also lose a lot of hair. But I know from my other skin, reindeer skin, that the fur will stop losing hairs over time. So, but I think it's cool, and it's my intention that these skins, reindeer skins, are going to stay out here in the camp, and also of course the shield and the other thing on the wall. And then I'm working on something on this one and this one. Not much, a little bit. I have to be careful not to overdo it. So, but I hope you like. And I actually got another thing I'm going to make. I made some things back home, and I'm going to put it up now, and it's not going to be in the shelter but outside. So hang on.
So now I have removed all the bark from the trunk, and I'm going to put it down in the ground. I have to dig a hole, and for that I actually have a new thing I would like to show you. So hang on.
Yeah, and this is the new tool I've got from a company, Zuno Loto, I think it's called. Of course, I put a link. It's called Wolf Thorn Hunters, and it's a shovel that can many other things that only shovel dirt. And when I open it, inside it's very exclusive, I think. This here, sort of a manual where you can see all the things that this shovel can be used for. And I show you a few of those. And but in here there's this little shovel in a sheath. I think it's leather sheath, but I'm not quite sure. Look at this. And a little handle for it that can be screwed on here. I think it's so cute. It's not bigger than my hand, you can see, and it's very sharp here on the edges. I can use it for chopping wood. And in this this end, they have actually come a fire steel in. Yeah, and you can use this to create sparks. I don't know if you can see it, but there's sparks here. So this little awesome shovel, a company has sent me that to make a review of it, and they say that this is a very special one, a original one, and you have to be careful not to buy some copies that are not so good at this. It's stainless steel and very durable. And the link I put in my video description is the place you are going to buy this, the original one. So now I'm going to show you how it chops small branches, and after that I'll use it for when I'm digging my hole. But I'm very pleased with this. I think it's really awesome, and the details and the quality is just, well, it's very nice, very durable and versatile. I love it very much. And here, yeah, you can see it. I think this is for opening beers and so on. But, and with this little sheath for it, you can see here, it fits nicely. And the back, you can attach it to your rucksack or wherever you want. Molly whipping, I think it's called. So, Wolf Thorn Hunters shovel, a very nice product. And now I'm going to chop a little thing so you can see how sharp it is. So hang on.
Let's see. Take some small branches. No problem. A little bit bigger. It's very sharp indeed. What about such a one? Yeah. This one. Yeah, nice little shovel. And of course you can see you can put it in different angles so you can dig with it like this, like a little pickaxe. difference. And of course, when you're out on the hikes and you have to make your thing, you can dig a hole with this, and it doesn't weigh much. I write down here how much it weighs. So I'm going to dig the hole for my little project. Yeah, and this one is a part of my new addition together with this. And I'll put it up, and then you can see the purpose for this. Yeah, and now I'm finished. And well, my idea is, this is a post that tells this is Kimber Camp. It's written here, yeah, it's written there in Rune, Kimber Camp, and a little horn on the top with some skin, and perhaps I put some kind of skull. I had a lot of those back home on it too. I don't know. This is what you see when you are arriving at Kimber Camp. The first thing you'll see, noticed, is this a sign that are going in here. Well, I think it's cool. And now I would like to show you some things that some of my subscribers have sent me. This whiskey is from a guy called Bushman Tom, and he sent me that, and it's a really great whiskey. It's very smoked taste, I like it very much, and it's very expensive, so I won't use it in my coffee, it's too expensive for that. But I can say, Tom, that I'm enjoying it back home very much. And when my son came home for Christmas, we drank some few whiskies of that. It's a really awesome whiskey. Thank you so much, Bushman Tom. And some other subscribers sent me this, and it's from Michelle and Ed from Pennsylvania, the USA. And they bought this for me on Amazon, and it came directly to me from Amazon. That was actually quite cool. And what is it? Well, it's a stove. It's a wood burning stove. And it's very compact, I think it's called. And this one goes on top here. And this one with the, where you can put your wood, your twigs. And I actually have some wood pellets with me. I would like to try it with that. And this one. And finally, this one on top, and this one can be folded out so you can have a large frying pan or something on this. And they also sent me this one so I can make sausages and so on when I'm out in my camp. And this one also have this for alcohol. If you put this down here and you pour alcohol there, it is actually an alcohol burner. So, but now I'm going to make my coffee using this, and I'm going to use wood pellets, as I said before. They should last longer, so I don't have to feed it all the time. Really cool. And thank you so much, Michelle and Ed, for this awesome gift.
I'm very grateful for that. You are kind people. Thank you a lot. Now, time for coffee. Just do it the easy way today. Well folks, this is all for now. Thank you for watching Kimba Bushcraft. I really appreciate that. I hope you like this little video and my new addition to my shelter and here in my Kimba camp. It's lovely to be out here today. You saw it was so good. No wind and just the blue sky. So it's awesome. The only thing that is a little problem is the it's not easy to film in this kind of weather because there's a lot of contrast in the footage. But I hope you enjoyed it anyhow. And now I'm going home and editing this video and launch it sometime tonight, Sunday night. I hope you like. Thank you again for watching Kimba Bushcraft. I hope you see you on the next one. Bye bye and take care.